Hey there, Mr. Toffee here. So this week has been a bit troubling for Xbox and action game fans out there. Scalebound, an Xbox One exclusive, is officially cancelled. It's not coming out, it's kaput. According to the official Xbox News, quote unquote, after careful deliberation, Microsoft Studios has come to the decision to end production for Scalebound. We're working hard to deliver an amazing lineup of games to our fans this year, including Halo Wars 2, Crackdown 3, State of Decay 2, Sea of Thieves, and other great experiences. According to IGN, when asked if the Scalebound IP is owned by Microsoft or by developer Platinum, a Microsoft spokesperson simply said, "We do not comment on the details of our business agreement with partners." That provided no additional comment when asked if Microsoft will seek to work with Platinum on a separate project in the future. Yeah, this is not good news, unfortunately. I mean, when we saw that original announcement at E3 2014, my god, this is exciting. And then when you saw the actual gameplay in 2015 and 16, holy shit, that was really cool. Just imagine if Platinum Games created their version of Monster Hunter. Imagine mixing Devil May Cry, snarky hero, with a big freaking lizard. A flying, fire-breathing lizard at that. Kicking ass with other bigger monsters. Heck, you get to kick the asses of other bigger monsters, bigger than your dragon, bigger than anything you've ever fought before, and it looks like it's gonna be multiplayer as well. Wow, just imagine four of you with four other dragons, with your armor, your crossbows, your weapons, your swords, fighting bigger monsters in an offline and online capacity, holy crap. And now we're not gonna see it. It's pretty bad news, all in all, considering that the game looks pretty finished. At least if the trailers are of any indication. Now, just to answer a couple of questions from my perspective, is this Xbox's fault? Well, that's tough to say. They have delayed games meant for 2016 to be on 2017. But hey, if it needs polishing, I'm all up for the delay. Is Xbox in trouble? No, they're not. Oh god, I hope not. I mean, just the lineup for this year sounds pretty alright. There's Halo Wars 2, there's a new Crackdown coming out, the Sea of Thieves, probably a new Forza title coming out end of the year. Oh, by the way, if you haven't played Forza Horizon 3, please buy that game. It's a godlike open world racing game. I think we're all good for the AAA front. Do you think Microsofts are being dicks for cutting off a game that's really close to development? There's actually more to it than that. I mean, games shutting down for undisclosed reasons, I mean non-public reasons, that's unfortunately a common thing. It really hurts even though when the game is near completion, but the reason, it's probably a legal thing, it's probably something that happened behind the scenes that no one's gonna be talking about because NDAs and whatnot. I'm actually more concerned about our good friends Platinum Games. Gonna play devil's advocate for the next few things I'm gonna say here. Scalebound may have been a good game, a great idea, but it probably needed more polish. And hey, maybe Microsoft may be a bunch of douches who are fine shutting down idea and concept after much hours of toil from Platinum. But, and this is just speculation here, Scalebound may even be a half-hearted effort that needed even more polish than usual. Maybe Microsoft was not confident about the product that was actually inside being developed. We don't know whether it's a full game or not, because what we got on trailers may not be indicative of the final product. And there's a couple of other examples from last year even. No Man's Sky. Watch Dogs, most cancelled or delayed games on E3, oh my throat. Platinum Games, for all the good they've done, they have a history of troubled development schedules. No company is perfect, guys. And you gotta remember, they're not like big, they're just mid-sized, like we're talking maybe 100 or less employees like that, working on multiple titles. I think last year there was Star Fox Zero, and there's the Ninja Turtles game, and they actually did not turn out that well. But hey, we should take heart. This same thing sorta almost happened with Metal Gear Rising. Remember that? That was a tech demo, that was that footage that came out in 2010. That game was supposed to be an Xbox Kinect game with the watermelon slicing and all. That got shelved, had more years to be developed, and bada bing, bada boom, we got ourselves a kick-ass 2013 action game that redeemed Cyborg Ninja Raiden further. Will the remnants of Scalebound be rebirthed into a new game in the far, far future? That could be likely, who knows. But that could also mean more lawsuits from Xbox, since they're the guys who had that idea first. They kinda owned it since it was supposed to be an Xbox exclusive. Now, can Platinum Games go around that? Of course, they're smart. They can turn the creatures to something else. They can keep that main concept, just make the heroes different, make everything else different, make it a steampunk universe for all I care, as long as it's a good game from Platinum Games. But if anything, if does it take away from all of this, this might be a sign that Platinum Games may need some time to reflect. Maybe not take on more than they can handle. Okay, so I know that the Nier 2 demo looks really, really good. I played it, it's fucking awesome, yo. But remember that Platinum Games is a mid-sized team, like I mentioned before. It has had its B-team working on some less than stellar projects, and had created some clunkers with its B-team. As much as I like Anarchy Reigns, let's face it, there's a reason why that game didn't get a really well-deserved acclaim. It wasn't really that fun if you don't like beat-em-ups. It's a very specific kind of game. Love the soundtrack though, but everything else? I can understand if you don't like it one bit. Still, the more I'm seeing Scalebound's trailers, the more I'm just watching this on this video right now, the more I'm like, oh god, it really hurts so goddamn much in the heart that I'm not gonna be playing this on this Xbox One. All I know is that a lot of you are pissed off right now. A number of you bought the Xbox One to play this hardcore game, only to find out it's cancelled. I feel for you guys. But hey, that's just to dim the brakes. Unless there's some new info that comes out after this video is released, we will never know. It's just gonna be an official, hey, wrong place, wrong time, something happened. There's always something fishy going on, but nothing's gonna come out yet. But as it stands, we've already had our first death of 2017. Scalebound, you will be missed. Do you think Microsoft is at fault here? Do you think that Platinum Games may have something to do with that? Who knows? Just like and subscribe to this video if you can, and tell me your thoughts about this whole conundrum on the comments box below. Stay safe, everybody.